honor to welcome 21-year NHL veteran Gary Roberts to the Coors side seats. We know about your commitment to fitness. We know your commitment to personal training. First, we want to talk about your commitment to a new program you're doing with Canadian Tire Jumpstart, Deck the Quads.
Deck the Quads, you like that? Have you guys been doing your lunges? I thought we could do a few of those tonight.
We could, we could. But I mean, there's so much to talk about.
It hurts. It hurts too much the next day.
Yeah, well, the next day is okay. But if you do like 500 a week for a few weeks, then it doesn't hurt anymore.
Oh my gosh. So tell us about Deck the Quads. What happened?
One of our trainers, Adrian Black, our head strength coach, came up with a program that he wanted to do through Jumpstart. Jumpstart's close to my heart. I do a charity event for them each summer, a golf tournament, in conjunction with Canadian Tire, our good friend Pat Higgins in Uxbridge. But we decided that we would try to raise funds for our youth that can't afford sporting equipment. So we have Deck the Quads. We put programming up every Monday. And your goal is to do 500 lunges a week. And you get a training program along with it to help guide you through your week every week for the month of December. And the funds go to Jumpstart, and CCM is a big supporter in that also.
And if you want to check that out, you can see that on your Instagram.
Yeah, and our good friends at Adidas. So if you donate over $75, you get a nice pair of training shorts from our friends at Adidas.
And perfect. I always point out Jumpstart, every penny goes to the actual charity because they cover the overhead, because a lot of the charities you don't know.
For
how
sure
much is going towards that. Okay, so you're huge into fitness.
Yeah.
You train guys in the offseason. You trained while playing. What's your daily routine like now?
Well, I have three young kids at home, so I try to get out early mornings to play some shinny. Mm-hmm. My wife lets me go Tuesday mornings to play shinny, so I do that Tuesday mornings in Newmark with a bunch of ex-players and young players that help push us along.
Who's some of the ex-players out there playing?
Mike Gartner, Wes Jarvis.
Gartner still have the hands?
He does. He can still skate and shoot.
Wow.
And he still gets mad at me when I don't pass him the puck. but we have actually a big breakfast game Tuesday. So losers buy breakfast.
Like that.
So I'm trying to get them to go to Nature's Emporium. Buy a nice organic breakfast. I don't like my chances. So my daily routine, I'd say I get up. I try to obviously help my wife get the kids to school. And then, I'm obviously busy with work and trying to build my business. So I have a great team of strength coaches and sports holistic nutritionists that we just try to build and evolve every year to get ready for next summer.
And in the off season, you're training all these, Connor McDavid's, you're known for training Steve Stamkos. Who's someone that you're training that people might not know that maybe surprised you with their commitment to fitness? Maybe someone you didn't think would be as into it.
Where are you going with this? Everybody wants to talk about Phil Kessel. Well, you know what? Phil's a fun, loving guy. If you talk to the players at the gym, we enjoy having Phil there. People look forward to him coming in. I mean, part of the environment we've created is a really professional environment. But it needs to be fun. It's a player's off season, right? The player's off season. They need to want to come to the gym every day. And Phil, I think when he gets there, he has a great, great time. And it's not like he's texting me in April saying, "Hey, when are you opening? When can I come?" I'm usually texting him, but he ends up coming, and he has worked very hard the last few years with us. And we realize that he, it's like a lot of players, everybody loves doing what they're good at, right? And we all got to get
that's
over
that. That's all through life, right?
But he's learned to evolve, and he's committed, and he's way more competitive than people give him credit for. So we thoroughly enjoy. He brings a real boost of smiles and energy to our program when he comes every summer.
It's kind of like Dan here.
When you first got into the NHL, was it the old classic, the off-season workout was guys go back to the farm, just work all summer on the farm?
Yeah, guys go play lacrosse, or guys just play a sport. Weightlifting wasn't really big. There was big players that played. Unfortunate for me at the time, when I went to Calgary, we had a really fit group. And I did not do very well in my first NHL training camp. My fitness was off the ice was not great. I was a runner and I was a hockey player. I had to learn to become a weightlifter, and of course, going through some serious injuries, I became more of a weightlifter and had to get my body back and build my body back up, so I was able to handle the daily stresses of the way that I played, to be successful.
We're going to get into rapid fire because you played with some amazing players over the course of your career, which spans decades. So we're going to start with Mats Sundin. Mats Sundin, how in shape was he when you
played? Mats Sundin, honestly, he was a horse. You know, I used to talk often to Pat that Mats needed to play more, right? Like Mats Sundin, if he only played 17, 18 minutes, he wasn't in the game. But if he played 21, 22, 23 minutes, he was a better player. I used to ride the bike beside Mats Sundin. We'd ride at the same RPMs and the same KPs, and my heart rate would be almost 15 beats higher than his.
Wow.
And he was a horse, great, great captain. One of my favorite teammates I ever played with. Mats Sundin never got the credit that he deserved when he was the captain of the Toronto Maple Leafs. Thoroughly enjoyed being a teammate and a friend of his.
How about the legend that is Lanny McDonald?
Well, what can you say about Lanny? Lanny took me as a young buck, right? Going to Calgary, dealing with the stresses of being a young player trying to make the NHL. He made me feel so comfortable. There's certain people you come across in your career that were so influential. For me, Lanny McDonald was that guy. Joe Nudyk would say the same. We got to Calgary. And wherever Lanny went, there was Joe and I, you know, following Lanny around. But he was so, his beautiful wife, Ardell, was so amazing, inclusive. Every time there was a team function, or it was usually organized by the McDonald's. We were fortunate as young players to be part of that organization, because there were so many veteran leaders in that organization that really helped us, not just how to deal with the on-ice stuff, but how to act off the ice. And it was a good organization to be part of. I didn't think that after my first training camp when Badger Bob said, you know, our worst conditioned player at camp was our first round draft pick.
I can't think of
it. And I was sitting there going, oh, somebody beam me up, send me back to Ottawa quickly.
So, did Lanny McDonald ever look young, or did he come out of the womb looking like he was 30?
Well, you know what? I was 23. I can remember like it was yesterday. Lanny McDonald was 36. We were on the blue line. We were accepting the Stanley Cup in the Montreal Forum. And I looked down, I saw Lanny, and he was you know, going to get the cup. And I'm like, oh my gosh, does he look old? Am I going to look that old when I'm 36 years old? Did you see that look he had in the Stanley Cup?
Yeah.
When I got to 36, I'm thinking about how Lanny looked when he was 36. But Lanny had that look, right? He was a snarly veteran guy at 36 years old, and what a storybook ending for him, and well deserved. One of the best human beings you could meet is Lanny McDonald.
And if you go to our Instagram stories, we're going to hear what Gary has to say about Jeff O'Neill and Jamie McLennan, because he played with both of them from the Overdrive show. But we don't have time for that. We got to get right to the Wheel of Destiny with Gary Roberts. Here we go, our studio wizard. We'll spin the wheel to determine Gary's fate to end this segment, which has been tremendous. I wish it could go longer, Gary. Are you nervous at all?
I want to do an impression. Well, that'll be a good one.
Oh, it's still going, man.
Oh, gosh.
Tell a joke. We've never had that one.
You have to tell us
a joke.
I have to tell you a joke.
That's right.
Gosh, now you stumped me. I was wanting why can't I get the headlock?
Nah, because everyone gets that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You've been headlocked too many times.
You know who gave me the hardest one?
No.
Who was
Timu.
It? Timu Solani.
Yeah. He had Stu Grimson one week, and he was gentle.
Grimson was
gentle? And you played with Stu, right, in Calgary.
Sounds like I played with everybody, right?
He did.
Stu wasn't much of a, he wasn't that gentle when I played with him.
No.
I don't remember, I wouldn't classify Stu as being gentle.
He
was pretty gentle.
He was with Dan, but Timu really took it serious.
How about in place of a joke, you tell us a funny story about Jeff O'Neill?
There's so many. How much time do I have?
We actually have no time. We're all out of time.
Gary, this was awesome.
Thank you for having me, guys.
Thank you
much appreciate
so much,
it.
It was a pleasure.
Let's start lunging, guys. We got a couple weeks left to lunge.
Still the cup.
All right, we're here with Gary Roberts. This is a special bonus segment of the Coors Side Seats because we didn't get time to ask Gary about two beloved TSN personalities, Jeff O'Neill and Jamie McLennan. And you played with both of them. So we have to start with the O-Dog. Whom you played with in Carolina.
Correct.
Wild times, I can only imagine.
Well, he was a young buck, and I was making a comeback in the NHL. So we became fast buddies, and I introduced him to fitness. And he introduced
He'd never had that introduction.
And he introduced me to trying to relax a little bit because I was probably a little too worked up. So we were a good combination for each other, and we ended up having cottages near each other in Muskoka for a few years. And I worked on his fitness and tried not to keep up with him on other areas of his life.
How are O-Dog's hands?
He was skilled. Like, he could shoot the puck. He had amazing skills. Jeff O'Neill was, probably could have scored a lot more goals than he ended up scoring. It's like anything, your career evolves, but he was an unbelievable hockey player in Carolina and had a great career.
What do you think of his fitness now?
Not so much. So like I love the guy. I want to help him.
Yeah.
And I call him once in a while. We have conversations, yeah. And we talk about salads, like you and I were just talking mm-hmm. about, kale salads. And maybe you can introduce Jeff, like just bring in an extra kale salads for him with poppy seed dressing like you like.
Okay. And
I
don't see that happen.
They're on sale right now at Sobeys.
So you recognize, like, he's on TV now, right? Like,
yeah.
You guys know, right? Like, TV. Like, I used to say to Glenn Healy and Nick Kyprios, you guys, like, maybe get on the different program. You know that TV makes you look, TV makes you look 10 pounds heavier.
That's right.
That's what they say,
absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely. But you also said that you were not surprised that Jeff ended up becoming a really good broadcaster.
Yeah, it's like I would say, Jeff is, one thing I say for Jeff, players maybe have to change personalities to do this. I find this is tough for me, right? Like, Jeff was a natural. He's always acted like he does today. It's not like he's grown into that. Like, that's Jeff O'Neill. And I think that's what I love about him. He's never changed through his career as a player and now as an analyst. I'm proud of him for how well he's doing. He's really good at it. And I guess, you probably could have called that when he played, because that he acts the same way today that he acted as a player. Hence why we loved him as a teammate.
And same with Noodles. He's a career backup, so his job during the game was to sit and
nice.
Talk to people.
That's nice.
Well,
Noodles,
exactly.
Career backup, yeah. Noodles.
He knows guy. What I mean. He knows.
Dan just called, yeah. Anyways, great supporting role. Kind of like you here.
Yes, exactly.
Great supporting role.
Thank you.
Great supporting
that's
role
That's what
for
my
Jay.
Job is. But he would sit and talk to guys all game.
He would, and he honestly, you come across goalies, and we all know that played. Some goalies are different, right? And they have a certain routine, and you don't get in their way on game day. But Noodles was one of those guys. He was kind of like a little bit of the glue in the room. He was a really fun guy to have in the dressing room, and it was, like you say, was great support for Roberto Luongo
yep.
when I was in Florida, and I think he really helped Roberto. When you have a backup in that situation that has his attitude. He only wants to see the team win, and he only wants to support Roberto. So he was once again a teammate that I came across and that I really enjoyed my time with Noodles in Florida.
Did you see Noodles becoming a broadcaster? Could you have seen
Look
that?
Look at all the goalies that have become broadcasters.
It's true, isn't it? Yeah. It's like catchers
Kelly
in baseball.
Rudy. I played with Darren Pang. Right? Darren Pang in Ottawa. I played junior hockey with him.
That's
like,
right.
So many goalies have become announcers.
Why didn't Vernon become broadcaster?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know why Mike Vernon didn't, but we'll have to.
It's not too late.
It's not too late.
Mike, give us a call.
I know he's got enough stories.
Yeah.
But another guy, though, like a great, like Mike Vernon was a glue. Mike Vernon, you would say, Al MacInnis won the Conn Smythe the year we won the Stanley Cup. But Mike Vernon, if it wasn't for him in the Vancouver series, game 7, we would never have had a chance to win the Stanley Cup. Mike Vernon was a huge, huge part in us winning that Stanley Cup.
This has been awesome, just hanging out with you and chatting. And,
I love it. I appreciate you guys having me down. And
yeah.
Always enjoy watching you guys. It's nice to have you back here where you belong.
Thanks,
yeah,
Gary.
Thanks
very much.
Yeah.
I feel like, too, like we're in pretty good shape. Like, I didn't want to come to this interview with Gary.
I'm surprised how tall you are.
Yeah, I get that a lot. But
yeah.
Were you talking to him?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
No, not you, actually. No. But we could work on our legs. Like, you guys are looking good. Like,
look how tight these pants are hanging on for dear life. Look at this.
I'm sending you guys a special program.
Tree trunks.
500 lunges a week.
Right.
Part of the program for the next. Do it for like, why don't we can push yours to January. Why don't you start in January, New Year's resolution?
And do the Deck the Quads.
Do the Deck
program,
the Quads. And we'll
you
do
can
it.
See on Gary's Instagram.
Deck the Quads. Do that for the month of January for you guys.
All right, I'll commit to that.
I mean.
But then these pants won't fit. Look.
Yeah,
they're already breaking.
Yeah,
it's all that muscle. All that Peterborough
you guys,
muscle.
You guys wearing those European suits that fit you really snug.
Indochino.